In most patients, they can have a complete organ removed. However, human beings cannot survive without the liver.
Hi, Dr. Raul.
Hi.
Can you tell us more about liver cancer?
Sure. The most common type of primary liver cancer is hepatocellular carcinoma. It's a type of cancer that originates in the liver. In Singapore, it is the fifth leading cause of all cancers and third leading cause of cancer-related fatalities.
What are some of the symptoms of liver cancer?
Unfortunately, in early liver cancer, there's often no symptoms. In more advanced disease, some symptoms may show. There might be unexplained or unintentional weight loss. There might be generalized lethargy or weakness. We may have a poor appetite. There might be a feeling of fullness, early satiety after a small meal. The tummy may feel very swollen or bloated, which may be a sign of a fluid accumulation in the tummy. In some patients, they may feel a mass on the right side of the tummy, where the liver sits. In more advanced disease, there might be evidence of yellowing of the skin or the eyes, which is a sign known as jaundice. And there might be visible vessels underneath the skin around the belly, which is a sign of compression of the veins due to the distension of the tummy.
What are some of the causes of liver cancer?
That's a very good question. The most well-known cause of liver cancer in Singapore is hepatitis B and C, which puts patients at more than 100-fold risk of development of liver cancer compared to those who do not have hepatitis B and C. Other causes of liver cancer in Singapore is what we call non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, in which a whole lot of liver tissue is replaced by fat in the liver, which results in inflammation and subsequent liver cancers. The other reason is alcoholism to a harmful extent, where patients may develop liver hardening and subsequent liver cancer. There are some unusual causes of liver cancer as well, like hereditary hemochromatosis, which is a genetic cause in which liver tissue deposits a whole lot of iron. But we do not really see so many patients with hemochromatosis developing liver cancer in our population.
Can you tell us how liver cancer is diagnosed?
Most primary liver cancers can be accurately diagnosed using dedicated CT scans or MRI scans of the liver. In addition, a blood test is also usually performed to detect the presence of a cancer-specific protein called alpha-fetoprotein. Alpha-fetoprotein tends to be increased in patients with primary liver cancer. Biopsy or sampling of the cancer tissue from the body is not usually required in patients with primary liver cancer. However, in certain cases where there is diagnostic uncertainty, then a biopsy may be required for further confirmation.
How can we prevent liver cancer?
You can lower your risk of developing liver cancer by leading a healthy lifestyle. Exercise regularly, control your body weight, and eat a healthy, balanced diet. You can also lower your risk of contracting hepatitis B, one of the major causes of primary liver cancer, by receiving the hepatitis B vaccine. Both children and adults are eligible to receive the hepatitis B vaccine.
Dr. Adrian, what is the prognosis for liver cancer patients?
Patients with primary liver cancer in the early stage may undergo curative treatment, and this will include surgery and local ablative therapy. In early stage cancer, after undergoing curative treatment, 5-year survival can exceed more than 40%. In primary liver cancer patients, several factors are considered before a treatment plan is drawn up. Number one, the stage of the cancer, whether it's localized to the liver or spread to the lymph nodes or surrounding organs. Number two, if there's any damage to the liver because of cirrhosis or chemotherapy or previous radiotherapy. Number three, the health of the patient, whether the patient has any medical problems that may preclude aggressive treatment. And number four, the availability of specialized treatment in the center or the institution that the patient is being seen. In primary liver cancer patients, we see the patient and they are assessed by a team of specialists before an individualized treatment plan is drawn up for them. This takes into account all the different factors that I've mentioned, as well as the wishes of the patient and their loved ones.
how is liver cancer treated?
In selected patients, surgery offers the best chance of cure and long-term survival. Surgery can be in form of resection to remove the tumor with surrounding liver tissue. In most patients, they can have a complete organ removed, such as the breast, the colon, and even the entire stomach. However, human beings cannot survive without the liver. Fortunately, the liver has regenerative capabilities, and in patients who are properly assessed, prepared, and with advanced surgical techniques, surgery can be performed safely, leaving sufficient liver for the patient to live a normal life. In selected patients, minimally invasive surgery such as laparoscopic or keyhole surgeries can be performed with safely, and this allows advantages of a smaller wound, faster recovery, faster return to work, without compromising the oncological outcomes for the patient.
Ablation techniques or minimally invasive treatment modalities which are available for treating small liver cancers up to 3 centimeters in diameter. Ablation technology utilizes heat energy to kill cancer cells whilst trying to preserve the surrounding normal tissue. The outcome or results of such ablation techniques for small liver cancers is comparable to that of surgery. In certain patients, ablation or surgery may not be suitable, and in those patients, we have to offer localized chemotherapy or radiotherapy as alternative treatment modalities.
For treatment of liver cancer, another modality that can be offered to patients is liver transplant. Liver transplant typically is offered to patients who have multiple liver nodule, their cancer is recurrent, or they have advanced underlying liver disease. Liver for that purpose of transplantation can be obtained either from healthy living related donors, in which a part of their liver is taken for transplantation, or from a patient who has already diseased and blessed their liver. If liver transplant is offered to patients, they will need to undergo extensive medical evaluation for suitability of liver transplantation.